Explain what you're doing.
Well, we're thirsty.
So I'm just pumping some water into our container.
Well, this is our campground, or our campsite for the first night. Right there is where we put our tent. Dad's brushing his teeth right now. But right here's the shot of the lake. It's a nice little lake. It's the only campground on the, our campsite on the lake, which was real nice because we had the lake to ourselves. So we're gonna go off that way this morning to the next portage to get to the other lake. Right here is our little fire pit. It's kind of windy today. So hopefully it doesn't impede us. There's the mess kit area. It's day one, well, officially day two, but
campsite
one, yeah. Going through all our gear, just packing up. It's a little after nine, it's like two after nine. I've been up since, 6:15. It's cold this morning. It's like 35 this morning, so it got down into 20s last night. It was cold. Today is supposed to be nicer. It's supposed to be like 65 today.
That'd be about 58.
So it's about 58 right now, Ryan said. So, just getting everything ready, getting ready to go, head out. We're gonna try to make Horse River today. So, hopefully we can do it. Let's see if we can get that bird. Yeah. Saw some bald eagles the other day. And a hawk. I don't know what kind of bird that is, it's hard to tell. I got a couple birds over there. But it's just beautiful country. There's our canoe. So, alright, well.
I have an extra bag in here.
No, I don't think you do.
Well, we're gonna finish packing up and then we'll head out. So, alright. This is Dresden PI1. See you later. Portage one on our second day out, first full day. We are leaving Sand Pit Lake and we're heading into Tin Can to get out to Horse River. This portage was a little tricky to find. It was in a marshy area. We thought it was on the other side of the lake, but it wasn't. So we'll see how things go. It's a nice easy portage. That's nice. First portage of the day. We're doing a double carry with all our gear first and then the canoe after that. So didn't you say this was a 160 rod, Dad?
Yeah.
This is a 160 rod portage. So it's a good little jaunt, but it's almost perfectly flat, so that's nice. Got cliffs on both sides. There and right there. So kind of in a valley, little gorge. So stick with me. It's Tin Mike. Just about there. Not if you can see that. Little inlet over here. Nice little lake. All right, this is the morning of our second full day, our third day out. It's our campsite from last night. We're packing up, just about to leave. Here, maybe 10 minutes or so. Gonna leave, but there's Ryan. He is tired, it looks like. Right behind Ryan, where that bear spot is, that's where we put our tent last night. Over there's the canoe, and Dad is getting ready. Our fire area. It wasn't a bad campsite. The only problem was we got here at about 8 o'clock. So we set up camp fast. I don't know if you can see it. The problem is today, or yesterday, we were heading right through that area. I don't know if you can see it, but that's a waterfall. All the way out there. Can't really see it. But we were heading over there last night thinking that was a campsite. But that's actually the portage for today to get around the waterfall. And it's not clearly marked on the map, so luckily we were able to notice that it's a waterfall. Otherwise we might have been going over. So, but this is what lake is this?
Crooked Lake.
We're on Crooked Lake right now. Today we're gonna go up and around the waterfall, the portage, and go up Crooked Lake all the way up to a spot on a series of islands. There goes a little bird. And we're probably gonna make camp, and we're gonna have a layover day and stay there for a day and do some fishing and clean up and just relax for a day or so. Horse River took longer than we expected because the portages were not clearly shown because everything's so high because it just melted. All the ice melted off like last week, so everything is so high. The water level is so much higher than normal that it's hard to distinguish the portage trails. So that took us quite a while to get through. But we made it. We're gonna push on today and get to that campsite. We'll make base camp there, and I'll do some more videos and pictures there. Right now it's just been kinda getting used to it. It's kind of a calm lake today. Yesterday the wind was blowing so hard. That it was a struggle, but it's not a bad lake. We'll do some fishing later, hopefully catch some fish. What's funny is this lake must be sitting up higher because back the other way, back this way, there's a waterfall, like I pointed out. Over here, right that next to that rock, there's a waterfall. And then let me go this way. And then right there's a waterfall and rapids as well. So this entire lake, it's surrounded by waterfalls. So we'll see how they are. One of them looks pretty big. So we'll see. Saw a couple bald eagles this morning roosting right next to our camp. Saw a grouse. So it hasn't been bad. It's been kind of nice, peaceful. Haven't seen anybody else around. So, and it looks like it's starting to rain. Yeah. Forecast did call for rain, so hopefully it's not too bad. But about ready to go. Say hi, Ryan. Yeah, it is. There's Dad who's washing his hands. Anything you want to say?
Bring less food.
He recommends bringing less food. He's the one who has to carry the food pack, so it's quite heavy on the portages. But so we'll leave here in a few minutes and then get going. So there's a little bird down there. Getting bugs off the water. Okay. Alright, well, we'll see you after the falls. Alright, right now we're taking the portage around the falls. We're coming up to look at the falls real quick. Here's Dad. Just to see what it looks like. Whew, they look pretty nasty. Come up here and woo-wee. Wow. Yeah. We would have been in trouble. Crazy. And I think we almost went off this thing. Jeez. Ryan. Getting video and picture. Crazy. Think we were like right there. Almost went over. See what is this way. Moving very quick. They probably went around.
the portage. Canoe it over.
Yeah, we'll get down there and come up. All right, let's go ahead and get 40.
Yeah, we'll get a good one.
Nice and quiet.
Water must be pushing out from that lake here. You can't get a single drink. Huh? So the water must be pushing out from that waterfall somewhere, but you can't, you're fighting keeping it straight.
They're making fun of me.
Huh? This looks like the rock face. Pictographs coming up. Now let me get closer to it.
Possibly some pictographs coming up right up there.
Indian pictograph. Yeah, well, I think it's the next outcrop. See where that big nose is sticking out? I think that's where it's at. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, yeah.
Thank you. on the first portage of the day. It's Wednesdays. Wednesday afternoon. We left camp about 10 o'clock and then we had to get through two bays, Thursday Bay and Friday Bay, and it's very, very windy today, so we were facing white caps and water all the way through. So it took us about 2 hours. It was a long, hard haul. This is a 163 rod portage. We already took the packs. Now we're going back for the canoe. It's really, really muddy and mucky through here. Right here. It's all through here. So, this trail that we're walking on is, I don't know if you can see it very clearly, but wolves, a pack of wolves use this trail.
Get it, come right over top and shoot down.
And let's see if we can get this. Looks like a pretty good set.
So, that's two different kinds of tracks.
Yeah.
One, two, three, and this has got one, two, three, four, five. This is two different tracks. We'll have to find out what they are.
So we found fur down the trail later, and I'll show you guys that. So it's an interesting trail. We're getting into, what lake are we going into? Chippewa. Chippewa. Going into Chippewa, Nicky, and then Wagash. And we might stay at Wagash. Depends how late it gets, so. We'll see. Not bad right now. A lot of birch trees in this area. Good place for an ambush from an animal standpoint. I don't know if you can see him up ahead. Dad's struggling. Really marshy, muggy. Gorgeous day out though. Gorgeous. Getting lots of sun. Enjoying the water, the weather, and this beautiful day. Later on today, we have this portage, another portage, and then after that, there's a 363 rod portage. It's just a little under a mile. And depending on how we feel when we get to Wagash, we're thinking maybe do that portage tonight or possibly tomorrow, depending on the time and how we're feeling. So we'll have to see, because that's a long portage, a very long portage. And we're all kind of beat with that the bays, how windy they were. So we'll see. I don't know if you can hear it, that wind. The wind is blowing really, really hard. Through here, it's hard to tell because obviously the tree is all around us, but out on that lake, it is white caps galore. Oh, it's not bad. We'll see. We'll see what we decide to do. Not sure yet. It was supposed to rain the last couple of days, but thankfully it hasn't. It's been two beautiful days, except for the wind. But other than that, everything's been great. It's been nice and warm. I think it's supposed to be close to 80 today, which is going to be nice. Hot. First day we went out, it was like 50 something. So it'll be nice. Hopefully can end the week. Oh, look at that skull. I don't know if you can see it. Looks like a beaver skull. Huh. Cool. Something got a hold of it. So, we'll see. So, just about to get the canoe and head back the other way. So, here's the lake. You can kind of hear the water, the wind. There's my dad waiting. Just show you real quick how windy it is out there. I don't know if you can see these white caps. But it's really windy.
this is not a very fun portage. This is not a long one, but it is extremely straight up. And I am going to try to videotape these boys carrying this canoe straight up the hill here, which is not going to be an easy task for them. And they are working together because this is straight up. I know it's going to be shaky because I'm trying to walk backwards up the hill. They're still coming up the hill. It's straight up, man. Still coming up this hill.
What?
And I'm breathing heavy. Just trying to stay ahead of them and record them. Oh boy, this is a tough one. It's not a long one, but it's like straight up. I mean straight up. And here we're getting to the top now. We got a little plateau here, and then we go back down. We got a flat spot here for a while, and then it's down from here. I feel their pain. They are struggling. That was a long one. All right. It's easier to walk forward so I can get this a little bit. And I'm going to stop here and I'll get you on our way back. Now they're starting their portage back down now. Back down to the lake. The next lake. This is, I believe it's Wawgosh Lake. We're trying to get to minimally. What we have to do is pack our stuff down first. And then go get the canoe because it's just too much for one trip. And that was a tough one there. They're a little bit tired on that one.
You should have just put your head in the middle of it, right?
This is Wawgosh Lake. And our next portage after that is a mile long portage, but we wanted to get to this one for sure before we tackled it. I'm trying to get out here and give you a little angle of the lake, much as I can see without getting out in it. So there we go.
I don't know if you can hear me or not, but tonight we're gonna have a big dinner. We went through that mile portage and we're starving, so I'm gonna cook up some dinner. We're gonna have Thanksgiving dinner. It's mashed potatoes, stuffing, chicken, and cranberries. So I get that going here.
Chili.
I'm sure it was. Hey Ryan, were these just regular cranberries or craisins?
No, these are craisins.
Alright. Add some stuffing. Hopefully this is enough. Water. That's just about there. So now I'm gonna add some more craisins to add some more flavor. Thank you.
that or dump some of mine into yours. But now it's gonna be through.
Thank you. Alright, this is our campsite. Our fourth campsite. It is Thursday morning. We were exhausted yesterday after our long day of paddling and our three portages. One of them was straight uphill. The other one was a 328 rods, which is well over a mile. And we did that three times. We were battling the wind on every single lake we were on, so we were exhausted. So we came into this campsite, which is a very nice one. We like this one the best so far. So I'll take you a tour. We're breaking camp slowly. We all got up late, so we're gonna break camp and then we're gonna head down to Fort Town, set up camp down there this evening, and then stay there all day tomorrow, and then get out early Saturday morning. But I'll just take in a little tour of the camp. So here's the fire area right here, getting our snacks out, our lunch for the day. Fire area. There's Ryan and Dad getting their sleeping stuff done. Right there. Right up over here. Where we're
so far, this
stuff
is
drying. Yep, this is his favorite camp, it's Ryan's favorite camp, and it's my favorite camp, so. It's very kinda, it's off on a point and very in the woods, so.
Tell the camera how we decided to use this camp.
What?
Should you tell the camera why we decided to use this camp?
If you want to.
We had to pick a number between 1 and 50. Whoever wins, we get the move on. I won, we came to this campsite. So. You're welcome.
I was not happy at the time because I was exhausted. My wrist was hurting and it was not good. But it's a nice campsite. It's our stove area. So, this is a nice campsite. Shaded and secluded. Take you back here to the latrine. It's a little ways to the latrine too, surprisingly, and you have to go up this big old rock here. So it's not fun to do this in the middle of the night. And last night I woke up in the middle of the night and I heard wolves howling, so that was kind of cool to hear. But there's the latrine. Don't know why it's not focusing. There's the latrine, so it's a decent ways back here. But it's a gorgeous, gorgeous campsite. Get a shot of the lake through the trees here. Maybe if my camera wants to focus. There. So, it's not bad. Not bad at all. See if I can get down here without killing myself. So, not a bad campsite. Get a shot out here of the lake. It's nice and calm right now. Yesterday it was windy as all get out. find, looks like he's trying to get service. Trying to check his messages. So, gorgeous lake. Nice and calm. Right now. We gotta go up that way around that point.
Look at that, it's set.
What?
It's set. Second try.
Up and around. Doesn't want to focus for some reason. That point. So, hopefully the wind stays down and we'll be fine, but we'll see. Gorgeous lake. All the way on the other shore. Sorry, it's still shaky. Gotta go up around that point right there. And as you can see, that's a good ways away. I'll take you and show you where we want to go. Anything yet?
Yeah, it comes and goes. My message went out. Is it 11:30 our time or this time?
It is. No, chapstick. 11:30 our time, right now.
Getting a signal from the goat.
The gorgeous lake. Maybe I can send out a message.
SOS.
SOS. No. I have my t-shirt on.
Must be mine.
Must be. I'll get it here. Alright. Let's see if we can see this. We are right here. This is that long portage right there from Wagash Lake. So, we're right here. We're planning on coming all the way down here. Do one portage, two portage, coming all the way down to Boot, three portage, into Four Town Lake. And then we're thinking about staying at one of these three campsites right here. One of those three. Hopefully that one, if we can. Because then all we gotta do is wake up early Saturday, come down and do
these three portages in a mudrow and then come back out. So, but we started in mudrow right here, went into sand pit, we stayed there our first night, came into Tin Can Mike, into Horse, all the way up to Horse River. Horse River was fun because the portages were not marked correctly on the map, so it had lots of rapids. So we went up Horse River. We were going to stay at these campsites right here, but there's a waterfall right here, and the portage is right next to the waterfall. It was like 8 o'clock at night, and we were like, no. So we came back and stayed here, which was not a bad campsite. So then we went into the portage on Tuesday. And we went up Crooked Lake, seen pictographs here, all the way up. All the way up. To here. We stayed that our third night. Right there. We were gonna stay right here, but it was really, really windy. And had a lot of ticks. So we stayed here. And then that was not a bad sight at all. But it was still kind of windy. And then yesterday, we went from here all the way through Crooked into. Oh, my hat's blocking it. Try that. Into Thursday Bay. Up over this way. Seeing the Buick. The 1926 Buick that somebody drove up here years ago and got stuck, so they just left it there. We seen that there. That was kind of cool. And we came from there all the way down into Thursday Bay. This was yesterday. Down. Did one portage. That wasn't too bad. Down to Chippewa. These areas were really nice. They were marshy and had lots of like river flowing areas. That was nice. Nikki, and then we were gonna stay in Wagash. Right here. But Ryan didn't want to. He wanted to go on with the mile portage. I did not. I wanted to stay there. I was exhausted. It was like 4 o'clock at that time, so I just wanted to stay there and camp, but
and my socks.
He won, so we did this mile portage. That was hard, very hard, and then we came into Gunn, came all the way out here, and then we stayed there, fourth night, so, it's a very nice campsite, very nice. So that's where we're going today. We're just moving slow today. Whoa, camera's going whopper jawed. Just moving slow. We're tired. But not bad. Not bad at all. Leaving firewood for the next people come around. So, all in all, it's been a fun trip. I've enjoyed it immensely. So, stay tuned. See what else is gonna happen.
coming to our first portage of the day. It's from Gun Lake into Fairy Lake, I believe. Fairy Lake. It's a... Nah, it's decent size. It's a 120. Or a 53. 50. It's a 50, sorry. It's 50, so it's not a bad. It's decent. So, we'll see. Right there is up where we're going. Right up in there. So, we'll see how it goes. It's been perfectly calm today. It's been wonderful. So, we'll get down into Fort Town today. Set up camp and spend the day just kind of chilling, relaxing. So, wonderful, calm day. So this is the portage from Gun into Ferry. It's not bad, it's a little muddy, but for the most part flat, which is nice. We just took our packs. Now we're going back for the canoe. So it's hot today. There's no wind, which I'm glad there's no wind, but it's hot. Whew. Really muddy right in there. A little rocky, but otherwise it's not bad. And there's the canoe. I don't know if you can see it. There it is. So, short little portage. Not bad. And there is Gun Lake. We just came from. So, get a shot real quick. Right there. We came all the way over from that point. So, not bad. Thank you. this is a sheep, matey. Recording. No way. Recording. This is a sheep, matey. Recording. No way. Recording.
Okay, you're good. I don't see anything. Yeah. You want me to tie you off? It is. So this is the first portage of the day. It's only 10 rods. It's a doozy. Whew. I don't know if you can see that waterfall down there. That's what we're going around. It'll be fun taking the canoe around. That's good fishing right there. First portage, that's it, but I don't know if you can see it. Over there is another waterfall, and that little ridge is our second. Here we go. Okay. there is the water. I don't know if you can see it. Where are we putting this thing? Ready? Huh? Man, there's rocks, man. Okay, hang on, there's rocks. A little to the left, Ryan. We want to go over here. All right. Log.
Well, there's our bear bag. Every night we have to put it up in a tree. And it's a pain in the butt to do. But it's to protect us from bears. And pretty far off the ground. So no bears are gonna get us. This is the campsite at Mudrow Lake. Last night of the trip.
Ryan and Dad sitting by the fire. So, just relaxing. Show you the lake here. It's the only campsite on the lake, so it'll be nice and quiet tonight. Nice and quiet. And there's a loon out there. Where'd he go? There he is.